الحمد لله وحده، والصلاة والسلام على من لا نبي بعده. أما بعد، we have been doing lessons on Tajweed and the aspect of Tajweed which deals with the qualities and sifat of Huruf. We started a few weeks ago. So there are certain qualities that have their opposites as well. So we have covered the first set, which is about hams and jahr. Hams being when there is a breath sound continues with the letter. When you pronounce those letter, there is a breath sound continues to come out because the vocal cord is still open. And the mnemonic to remember is فَحَسَّهُ شَخْصٌ سَكَتْ أَفْ أَحْ أَسْ أَهْ أَشْ. So the breath sound continues. And then there's another group whereby the letters have their two opposite surfaces closing straight away when you pronounce them in their silent state, in their non-active or inactive state. And these letters are Ajid, Qatim, Bakat. So you cannot continue the sound, whereas other letters you can continue with the sound. So you could do with prolongation with the sound. For example, you can say Ash, there's a breath coming out, there's also sound coming with that. Likewise, if you take any other letter, if you want to continue the sound, you can continue the sound. It doesn't stop. So, Shadid letters, when they stop quickly and you cannot maintain the sound, and the opposite of that is the letter of Rikhawa or Rikhwa, softness, where they do not close very quickly and hence there is still ongoing sound. And there is a group in between in this category, which is the third category, the middle category, Tawassut, the category of Wasat, the category of Bainiyah, between the two groups. And they are neither Shadid nor have they got Rikhawa. They are rather in between. Because although the makhraj opposite surface or opposing surfaces stop suddenly, there is a side passage or a different passage for the sound to continue. For example, when you say an, the tip of the tongue goes at the top and it blocks off the makhraj an. But half of the sound is coming from the nose. That continues. So, an. And that is why they are called bainiyah, because they are stopping, the makhraj is stopping straight away, yet there's another passage for the sound to continue. In the first group, it was the breath which continues. In the second group, it is your sound which continues. Today, we go to the third quality of the letter, and this is called the quality of isti'la and istifal. So isti'la is means to elevate, to make something go high. What happens? The base of the tongue gets elevated. When you pronounce these letters, there are only seven of them, then you elevate the base of the tongue up. And so they become high, elevation of the sound. Whereas all the rest, like 21 other letters, you do not elevate. You rather keep the base of the tongue lower. So they are called istifal. So if you look at these letters, they are called kha, sad, wad, ghain, ta, qa, and wa. So khussa, dag, tin, qiv. Remembering like that. So they are all pronounced with the elevation of the base of the tongue. And the opposite of that is you do not elevate the base of the tongue. You just pronounce them flatly. Okay. So, huruf-e-musta'aliyah with isti'la in it. and حروف مستفلة. So if you look at that, for example, قاف and كاف, they are both pronounced from the base of the tongue. Up, up. But what do? You elevate the base of the tongue up, up, up. It goes up. Whereas for كاف, أك, it comes straight down. You do not create that small, you know, dip in there with the tongue going up and keeping a small dip, which you do for قاف, but not for the كاف. So one is flat, أك, أك, and as opposed to أك, أك. Okay. So the heaviness or the فخامة or تفخيم is, that's what you do. You make it heavy, make it feel quite heavy and elevated. So تفخيم and ترقيق are the words or the terminologies used for them, heavy or light. ترقيق means very, very fluid, liquid, thin, lean. تفخيم is heavy. Okay. And then certain letters you pronounce with quite heavy, especially if they have fatha. So you say qala as opposed to qala, 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 yaqulu, qila. Okay, so you do not say qala, 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 qala. That's a flat tongue. The base of the tongue is not elevated. You say qala as opposed to qala. So if you look at all the letters of Arabic language, khussa, dhaghtin, qil, these seven are pronounced with elevation of the tongue all the time. They are called hurufi musta'liya. These are the letters which are pronounced by elevation of the base of the tongue. Akh, kha, kha, sa, fa, wa, gha, ta, qa, wa. Now some people pronounce that by only rounding their lips. They say khwa, 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 or swa, twa. That's wrong. It's not about rounding your lips. It is about elevation of the base of the tongue. And sometimes it feels like, or some people try to make it slightly rounded, but that shouldn't be the case. Ideally, when you practice it and you continue to practice, you only pronounce it by elevation of the base of the tongue rather than rounding your lips. You shouldn't be saying kha or qala. No, it should be kha, kha, qala, qala, qala. Okay? Rest of the 21 letters, they are alif, lam, and ra. In certain situation, they are pronounced with full mouth, with elevation of the base. Sometimes they are pronounced with lowering of the base of the tongue. So they have got middle category. The rest of the letters are just pronounced by lowering of the base of the tongue. So حروف مستعليا. So حروف مستعليا are seven, and they have their counterparts as well. So for example, not all of them, but at least three of them. Fa, fa, fa is pronounced with the base of the tongue being elevated. Fa. What about seen? You do not elevate the base of the tongue. So fa is from مستعليا group, and seen is from mustafila group, and they both come from the same makhraj. They are both pronounced from the same point. So if you do not make it elevated, you are not distinguishing between the two. The word may have different meaning because of the problem with the sifa of isti'la not being pronounced properly with regards to saad. So it is important that we pronounce it with elevation of the base of the tongue. Likewise, ta, ta, and ta, 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 and ta. They are both pronounced from the same makhraj. Say at, at, ta, at, at, ta. So ta, tip of the tongue, just touching the base of the incisors, the upper incisors from inside, you just touch their base where they're inserted into the gums, and you pronounce at, or you, of course you do hums right at the end, at, because it's a shadid letter with hums at the end. So if you say at for ta as well, how would you know which is which? So you have to say at for ta and up, qalqala, up, here the sound continues because of qalqala that you do in the shadid letter, up. So if you do not make it elevated, it would be like ta. If you say ihdinas si, this is seen. So you have to say ihdinas si, elevating the base of the tongue. Si, ra is mufakham here as well, full mouth. Si ra. And if you say tal, that is ta. It should be tal, elevating the base of the tongue. Sirat, all three are. Sad, ra, and ta are with elevation of the base of the tongue. And if you do mustaqim, then you have done the opposite. This is ta with two dots. So musta, seen is flat. Ta is flat. And qaf is heavy. So mustaqim. You elevate only for qaf in this case. Not for seen, not for ta. Otherwise, they will become sad and ta, which are in sirat. So it is extremely important to distinguish. And many people make mistakes there. So that's the second one with this counterpart. So sad and seen, they are opposite to each other. Likewise, ta and ta, they are opposite only because of having different sifa in this regard. One is from musta'aliyah group, and other one which is seen on ta are from mustafila group. And third one is wa. Ral and wa. They are both pronounced from the same makhraj. The tip of the tongue touching the tip of incisors. Ra. Alladhina. Iza. A'uzu. The difference between the, and wa likewise, awim, the difference is elevation of the base of the tongue for wa and not for zal. So zal is in this group, wa is in that group. You have to have that distinction, otherwise there will be a problem. And for qaf and kaf is from this group and qaf is in that group, there is, because the makharij is not exactly the same, but they're very close to each other. So qaf is heavy, means elevation of the base of the tongue, and kaf is not. So ak-a. So make sure that we understand the distinction and difference between these letters, because that is what would distinguish them very clearly. Otherwise the meaning can be different. Okay, let's just read a few ayat, inshallah ta'ala. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم تنزيل الكتاب after ta there is alif, smooth alif, which you pronounce the smooth alif. Kitabi, alif mad, alif maddiya, because of fatha before it. Minallahi, we said lam at times can be heavy. So the lam of Allah is heavy when it is preceded by a letter with a fatha or dhamma on it, zabar or pesh on it. So minallahi, not minallahi, minallahi al-azizil hakim. عزيز الحكيم, that sifa of whistling. عزيز الحكيم, that hums has to be there. حكيم, Why we prolong Hakim? Because the second last letter is Ya Maddiya. Ya Maddiya means a silent Ya preceded by a Kasra letter. So Kaf has Kasra and you are stopping at the last letter, obviously. So Hakim, if you do not stop, you do not prolong it. This is called Maddul Arid Lissukun. Inna Nun Mushaddid is done Ghunna on all the time. Inna Anzalna Ilaykal. Ikhfa again. Anzalna. Why are we doing Mad in Inna and Anzalna? Because this Alif Sakina, which is a Mad letter, is followed by Hamza. Hamza, which is Anzalna Hamza. Alif is only Alif when it has no other Fatha Dhamma Kasra on it. If it has Fatha Dhamma Kasra, it becomes Hamza. So that is Hamza. It prolongs that Alif Maddiya. And likewise, Na, there's a sign of Mad, which you know, and you prolong for that reason as well. But you should know why we do it. إِلَيْكَ الْكِتَابَ إِلَيْ لَيْ لِين Ya Sakina preceded by a Fatha letter. لَيْ إليك الكتاب بالحق بالحق You elevate the base of the tongue بالحق فاعبد الله You do not do with jerks فاعبد الله فاعبد That's wrong Because this is not شديد letter Hamza is شديد letter That's Hamza which is شديد عين is not You can't say إياك نعبد إياك نعبد إياك نعبد This is in between one. It should be done slightly slowly. Slower than the شديد letter. So فاعبد الله Here, lamb of Allah is not pronounced with elevation of the tongue. Why? Because the letter before it has a كسرة. دال has a زير كسرة. فاعبد الله مخ Elevating the base of the tongue. Mukhlisal, sal, sal. Base of the tongue needs to go up. Mukhlisal lahuddin. Again, Maddul Ariz, Lissukun. Second last letter is Ya Maddiya. Ala lillahid. Ala lillah. Again, Lamb of Allah. We don't prolong, we don't make it heavy. Why? Because the Kasra letter. Is preceding it. So it's not Allah or Allah, it's actually illa. So lillah, lillahi, ala lillahi ddeenul khalis, kha, kha, not kha, 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 base of the tongue goes up. Khalis, lis, if you say lis, it becomes seen. Khalis, lis, wallazeena تَخَذُوا تَخَتَ is flat تَخَخَ تَخَذُوا وَالَّذِينَ تَخَذُوا 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 مِنْ إِخْفَى مِنْ دُونِهِ مَدْسِلَة كُبْرَى مِنْ دُونِهِ أَوْلِيَاءَ مَدْ and you stop at Hamza when it's silent with a jerk If you do not, أَوْلِيَاءَ مَا نَعْبُدُهُمْ Again, not with jerk. نَعْبُدُهُمْ إِلَّا لِيُقَرْ Elevating the base of the tongue. لِيُقَرِّبُ Ra is flat here. We covered that, why Ra is flat here. In you know, rules of Ra lesson. لِيُقَرِّ Flat. لِيُقَذِّبُونَ لِيُقَذِّبُونَ مَدْ لِيُقَذِّبُونَ إِلَى اللَّهِ لَمْ جَلَلَ preceded by فَتْحَ because it's إِلَى فَتْحَ زَبَر and Allah you connecting this lamb with that lamb إِلَى اللَّهِ زُلْفَى إن الله نون مشدد is غنة and لام جلالة is preceded by فتح of نون إن الله يحكم همس بينهم لين فيما هم فيه تليفون يخ elevating the base يختلفون إن الله لا يهدي من هو نون ساكنة followed by ها حروف حلق you do not prolong that من هو كاذب إخفى كاذب كفار رابط في الموت كفار لو أراد الله أن يتخذ ولدا لاصطفى صادف في الموت طابت في الموت حروف مستعلية لاصطفى مما يخلق في الموت خاء قاف يخلق ما يشاء سبحانه با قلقلة ساكنة با ساكنة قلقلة قطب جد سبحانه هو الله الواحد القهار خلق السماوات والأرض بالحق قلقلة again يكوّر الليل يكوّر الراء في الموت يكوّر الليل but lam is not يكوّر الليل ليلى يكوّر الليل يكوّر الليل على النهار ويكوّر نون مشدد غنة ويكوّر النهار را نهار على الليل ليل لام has فتحة يا ساكنة preceded by a فتحة letter it is lean وسخر الشمس والقمر قمر قابض في الموت heavy letter base of the tongue should be elevated قمر and ra as well كل يجري تنوين followed by ya is إدغام مع غنة كل يجري قلقلة لأجل مسمى لأجل لن becomes لم تنوين followed by ميم of يرملون إدغام مع غنة لأجل مسمى ميم مشدد always غنة and there's two فتحة you read one alif when you stop مسمى ألا هو العزيز الغفار غفار را في الموت غين في الموت صدق الله العظيم والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته